What's up everyone, Patrick here, and in today's video I'll be showing you how to use NordVPN on a Windows PC or desktop computer. Now, NordVPN is one of the top available VPN services on the market today, and if you don't know what a VPN is, it simply stands for Virtual Private Network, and it allows you to remain anonymous while you're browsing online. This is great if you're trying to stream region-locked videos or movies, or if you're trying to torrent and remain anonymous. Whatever the reason, a VPN is the way to go. And I'll include a link down in the description to NordVPN, so you can go ahead and download it and follow along with me today. And of course, I'll include any discounts or deals that come along with that. So jumping right into it, the first thing you'll do is head over to NordVPN.com and then download the app for yourself. After downloading and installing it, you can open it up from your desktop and log in. Once you're logged in, you'll be greeted with a nearly identical screen to mine, which is a map of the world along with all of these little location icons. Now, all of these icons simply mean that NordVPN has service available in those countries, and this is great, especially if you're trying to connect to a region-locked site or streaming platform and you need to appear like you're in another country. Now, clicking on any one of these will quick connect to the best available connection within that country for you, and then clicking on the disconnect button at the bottom will simply allow you to disconnect from that and you're no longer browsing privately. If you want a full list of all of the available countries, you've got that on the left side over here. Hovering over any one of these and then clicking on it will then allow you to obviously quick connect. But if you want to jump in and take a look at the specific servers or regions for yourself, you can click on these three dots or right click on any one of these. And if they have multiple regions available, you'll see a region drop-down list and a server drop-down list. Now, by default, all of these are set to the fastest, but you can go in and choose one that's better for you. Now, you might want to pick one that's closer, but that doesn't necessarily mean that it will be a quicker connection. It all comes down to the hardware and then your internet connection, just to the internet as a whole, because you're first connecting to your local line and then that's routing you all the way to your region and server for your VPN, and then that's taking you to your destination. So it's natural that there will be a little bit of latency or delay in that, but that's where NordLynx comes in handy. Now, NordLynx is a proprietary protocol, and VPN protocols are simply the way that your service is able to talk to the server itself. The international standard is OpenVPN, and that's the open source version, and almost all, if not all, VPN services have this protocol available. However, NordVPN and some other VPN services have their own proprietary protocols because they've invested an awful lot into their hardware and infrastructure and want to make sure you're getting the best bang for your buck while connecting to their hardware. Now, if you wanted to, you can go ahead and change these protocols as you see fit by going to the gear icon at the top and clicking on that. This will open up all of your settings. And from here, you can see the general settings tab, which is simply your launch options. All of these options are going to be self-explanatory, and that's through all of these different settings menu. But what we're interested in is the auto connect. This will show you whether or not you connect whenever you're on Wi-Fi, if you want your device to always, no matter what, be running with your VPN whenever you're connected to the internet. Then you would have this on. If you want a little more control, then obviously leave that off and turn it on with quick connect or directly to a region or server of your choice as you see fit. Now, just below that, you can see the VPN protocol section, and this drop-down list will show you all of the available VPN protocols that NordVPN has to offer. And you see the two different ones for OpenVPN, and then the recommended one, which is NordLynx, and the one that I'm already on by default. Now, obviously, you've got some more settings over here that you can jump into, and these are a little more technical that once you have a little more of an understanding of the application, they'll make more sense to you, but these are just general VPN settings, such as a kill switch. Whenever you're disconnected by your VPN on accident, then it will automatically disconnect you from the internet, so you're not browsing online unprotected. Of course, these are just personal preferences. Now, in order to head back to the menu, we'll just click that back button at the top left. And going back to the list on the left side, you can scroll all the way up to see your most recent connections, and just below that, specialty servers. Now, the purpose of specialty servers are just that, for special use cases whenever you're trying to connect for a specific reason, whether you're using an onion web browsing client or if you're trying to do peer-to-peer connections through a VPN service. Just like that, you should now understand how to use NordVPN on your Windows PC or desktop computer. And if you haven't already, be sure to check out that link below in the description with any deals or discounts along with it. Let me know down in the comments what your favorite feature about NordVPN is, and if you found this video helpful, please give it a like. I always appreciate it. And subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this one, hitting that bell for notifications. And until next time, thanks for watching.